Rooster. There's plenty of them out there. Now you can see what's attracting me to this one. Those lovely tail feathers. So first of all, we're going to place him. And I'm going to use some orange. We're going to make him a little bit brighter than he actually is, because we can do that. Alright, that's the tail comes up quite a long way, so his head is about two-thirds. That will be about there. There's a bit of that orange comes here with one of the feathers, and that's quite light there, so we'll keep that nice and sparkly. Now I'm going to go for a mauve because I quite like that intense violet. So just make it quite sparkly on top. That can join and that can run some bits. It's darker as we come down and that sort of follows through. So you're looking at the shapes all the time, and then he's got sort of a rounded bottom. The tail will come to there. Which means there's one leg here and the other leg sort of comes through from there. Now I'm going to dip my brush into some watery Prussian blue just on its own, and let's just get some of those feathers in. I'm going to use just a sort of a pinky burnt umber. Add some alizarin crimson into the burnt umber for his legs. Now he's standing on that one. And that one's sort of coming across. And whilst we've got those loose washes on our brush, what colour should we do the shadow? Let's go for a violet. I quite like the violet. And just let that run in. That anchors him down nicely. Because as you can see, there's no shadow on the photograph. Now, it was very sunny because I photographed him in Barbados. But I think the sun was overhead. So we've got to make up a shadow to anchor him down. Right, let's leave that to dry. Right, looking at this, it probably looks a little bit messy at this stage because these bits have run. But that is really good. We love it when that happens. Let's pop his comb in. And then he'll really start to look the part. So I'm going to go for a little bit of alizarin crimson and I'm going to mix some cadmium red into that. And his beak's quite low down. So I'm sort of looking at the shape, so that's part of where his eye is going to be. That sort of comes around, and then there's that comb that drops down, and then it sort of comes over his face and it ends about here. So maybe we need to just bring that forward a little bit. I'll just go over where the eye is going to go. We can pop that in a minute. It's looking magnificent already. Okay, now I'm going to mix some Prussian blue and some sepia together for those dry brush marks on the tail. So nice and thick, nice and gungy. And let's get some dark shapes into that. So dry brush. Look at how those feathers are sitting. Sort of a bit like a fan, how they come up here. Oh, he's so ruffled, he's beautiful. And another spiky one there. Wow, he is beautiful. Right, let's just get that beak in. Just point of the brush. So you don't have to change brushes. And the eye is sort of there. Just looking, I don't think I want any more detail. The danger is that you overdo it. So I'm going to leave him just as he is. So I hope you've enjoyed painting this cheeky little rooster.